as the war between Ukraine and Russia escalates, raw material prices are skyrocketing. As a result, fears of an economic slowdown continue to impact the financial markets. On March 8th, the KOSPI fell 1.09% to close at 2,622.4. It fell 20.7% from the all-time high recorded in July 2021. Typically, when it falls more than 20% from each high, it is considered the inner bear market. The KOSPI has already entered a bear market in January. On March 7th, in the New York Stock Exchange, the Nasdaq Index, which focuses on growth stocks, fell more than 20% from the peak in November of last year, and again another bear market. The global dollar has again become a haven. The depreciation of the won is sharpening. On the same day, the $1 exchange rate in the Seoul Foreign Exchange market closed at 1,237 won, up 9.9 won. In the last 3 days, it rose by 32.4 won. The prospect that the West, including the US, could impose sanctions on the import of Russian crude oil and natural gas severely dampened investor sentiment. International oil prices have surged to their highest since 2008, but the market is betting on the possibility of breaking above $200 a barrel. Nickel prices soared more than 90% during the day on concerns that other Russian materials might be banned, setting new all-time highs. Russia has supplied about 10% of world nickel demand. European natural gas and palladium prices also hit all-time highs. The bond market is sending signals that the recession is imminent. The yield gap between 10-year U.S. Treasury bonds and 2-year bonds has sharply narrowed from 0.51 percentage points 3 weeks ago to 0.22 percentage point now. Short-term bonds are mainly affected by changes in monetary policy due to inflationary pressures, while long-term bonds reflect future economic trends. Therefore, concerns that the Federal Reserve will raise interest rates at a rapid pace and slowing growth rate can be seen as a narrowing of the short-term interest rate differential. Ukraine and Russia are called European bread baskets. As wars between these countries intensify, world wheat prices are skyrocketing. Ukraine and Russia account for more than 25% of the wheat exports. In the past weeks, wheat prices have risen more than 60%. The term Grayliner was first proposed at the Davos Forum in 2013 as a term for grey goods. Michelle Buckler was the first to use the term Grayliner sauce. Buckler, who served as the director of the World Policy Institute, first presented the concept of a Grayliner at the World Economic Forum in 2013 and wrote a book called The Grayliner is Coming. Grayliners are large and can be seen from a distance. It means that when you get close, you can't do anything out of fear, denying the danger. In the book, she points out that the main reasons for the appearance of the gray rhino are a system that ignores red flags, ignores prevention of crises, difficulties in setting priorities, and lack of accountability. The gray rhino is a foreseeable danger, just as rhinos are naturally gray. We are talking about the danger we are well aware of. It looks good from a distance, but it means that if left unattended, it will be difficult to respond to. It is a risk factor that society is aware of and fully foreseeable, but easily overlooked due to constant warning. The reason gray rhinos are dangerous is, paradoxically, because they know it too well. Repeated warnings become dull. Even when signs of danger persist, the impact is not fully understood. In the end, it is impossible to fully respond. Because there is not enough preparedness in place.